Hello there, gamers. Oh yeah, we don't need this anymore. No secret stream? Oh, we'll probably do a secret stream. I just wanted to play some Yu-Gi-Oh! For a little bit. Thanks for an awesome year. Enjoyed your streams and videos. Can't wait what the new year brings. And hope you enjoy your new years. Why, thank you, Sir Frank Yu-Gi-Oh! Heck yeah, New Year's. However, it's not my new year for another 2 years. Two hours, I mean. New Year's chat and Spooter. Hello there, Delta. I'm in silver. Standard. Season 13 has begun. Ooh, I can play my Metal Zoa Labyrinth deck. Logs is so cool and mysterious. Why, thank you, Terabyte 79. There, I said it. Are you okay, Terabyte? Did someone pay you to say that? Was it Meowie? A family talk question. Okay. Let's see. Family talk question. Family talk question. What is something that you do that gives you the most personal satisfaction? The most personal self-satisfaction. Activate caddy. What do you mean by that? I don't know. What do I do that gives me the most personal self-satisfaction? Probably making YouTube videos? Happy New Year? Yeah, Happy New Year, super sexy shark. I ranked up with Pure Runic today. You monster. Whoa. They didn't have anything? They didn't do anything. And I bricked. I'm totally bricked up right now. I can't push. Maybe I can push a little bit. Not really. Oh, I probably should have attacked first. Okay. Stop saying bricked up. Shut up. Happy New Year. Happy New Year, gamer grandpapa. There'll be a year where I finally be my SO. Same thing I've been saying the last couple of years. I have questions for New Year. Let me go through those. Oh, fuck. These are question topics, better therapy. No, that's not it. How has my opponent, like, not done anything? Go to sleep? I have a question. Have the idea or is it developed? Old cards that made a competitive comeback. Like Super Rejuvenation or Neko Main King recently? Oh, I've made like 2 videos in that style. Thanks for the gifted sub, Dax Chewy. To the Speedroy Terror Top. Whoa. What's this one? Questions to start great conversations? No, not this. Wait, where the hell are my questions for the New Year's? Guys, I can't find my questions for the New Year's. The Higgin game, cozy conversations and pleasant company. Ooh, I drew into Metal Zoa. Oh my god, I can't believe I bricked this hard. Luckily, my opponent has bricked just as hard as I have. It's a stall bot. Tribute summon Metal Zoa. I have to, because I bricked so fucking hard. I drew all of my goddamn garnets. Thanks for the gifted subs, Terabyte. To Super Sexy Shark. Ooh. If calories didn't exist and all the food was healthy, what would you eat more often? Cheeseburgers. I'd eat cheeseburgers every day. Would there be more or fewer divorces if people could read each other's minds? Oh, these are good questions. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. More? I think there'd probably be less. There'd be a lot less miscommunication. People like to pretend like their inner thoughts are so dark. Okay. Terabyte is too generous. Terabyte is a very generous bloke. I won! Let's get deep questions. I can't find my New Year's questions. Are they downstairs? Maybe we check his deck? Alright, I'll check his deck. Okay. I'm not sure why they just kind of sat there and did nothing. This is my first time hearing Log swear without being censored. I'm not used to it. I don't swear. I am a non-swearer. I'm gonna go downstairs real quick. I think it might be down there. I'll BRB. Hello there. It is I, the Duel Lag. I am here to teach you guys. Hello, it's me, the Duel Logs. I'm a spider from the moon. This is a public service announcement in order to address some slander I've been seeing in chat. I've seen lots of people say that I'm from Jupiter, which is not true. Okay, now that we have that out of the way, let's go into this ad, because I'm probably playing this while I'm gone. How to make friends. I get this one a lot in chat. You know, those people say, hey, the Duel Logs, I don't have any friends. How do I make friends? And I say, well, why are you asking me? Like, I play Yu-Gi-Oh! For a living. You think I have friends? So anyways, let's go over some tips on how to make friends. Now, first step, the number one step, be the initiator. Don't wait for people to contact you. Have you ever watched a TV show or an anime where the main character is some dweeb, some loser, some absolute just nobody who does nothing? He has no skills, and yet he gets all these friends and things. You know, usually what happens is that other people reach out to him, and he doesn't have to do anything. Don't be that person. Be the side character. Be the side person who reaches out to the main character and forces them in all those adventures. That's how you do it. Waiting for things to happen is guaranteeing that they won't, unless you get lucky. And you probably won't. Also, when you talk to people, don't look for the right things to say. Just say what you like or dislike. I know this will cause you to have friction, maybe make some people not like you as much if they find out what you like or dislike, but it makes you feel like a more real person, and real people are more I can't find it. Here we go. I just typed it in Google and I found some stuff. It's just as good. Alright, let's play some more Metal Zoa duels. Any tips on a new Master Duel player? Do all the solo modes for tons of gems. I was listening to How to Make Freeze Propose. What? Friends Propose? Thanks for the gifted sub, Heratic. Or the Prime sub, I should say. Heratic Hercules. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Let's ask some New Year's questions. 20s New Year's questions. What was the best thing that happened this past year? She's a superlative right off the bat. Gosh, so many things good happened. I can't possibly narrow it down to just one thing. Best thing happened last year, I fell down the stairs. Classic GCT Yu-Gi-Oh. Your balls were stolen. Oh, there was just so many things that happened this year. I can't even think of which one is the best one. Dude, I'm totally drawing a blank. I have no idea. Did anything good happen? You guys know me pretty well. Is there anything good that happened to me this year? I can't think of anything. Ash Blossom. Ass Blossom. Meeting Aku Meowie. I guess. Anything else? I don't know, you got some subs, I guess. Money's always cool. Okay. We set all this shit. I could use that now, or I could just do this. The channel growth on Twitch and YouTube? I mean, like, it was better until a certain point. You got Twitch partnered? That was only because Twitch changed their rules on how I could get partnered. That's all it was. Going to the con? The con was a little boring, to be honest. You started a VTuber harem? I wish. That would be fun. I have lots of colleagues, and we only ever interact on stream. That's it. Money is always cool. Hell yeah, you guys know that. With money, you can, like, fund new YouTube channels. I had to tell my Pokemon channel people, I was like, hey, the channel didn't do so well in December. I have to cut the budget down by, like, 2/3. Things to shout into the void? Max C, that ain't gonna do nothing. Resume playing Yu-Gi-Oh! MD? I met Rosumi in 2021, though. That's not really a 2022 thing. I don't really care if she plays Yu-Gi-Oh! I was already a huge fan before she started playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Oh my god, I can use emotes. Hello there. I can't think of anything else. What else happened to me this year? No applicable card in your hand. Okay. Ooh. Okay, and then I want to use this card. This one. You got to play Labyrinth. I'm trying to think of something like big. There's something big happened this year. Something big good happened this year. You got a new boyfriend, the DPE? True, true. Very true. However, I'm not into men, so that's not really an accomplishment. Oh, I can use it this turn. I forgot I could use Welcome Labyrinth this turn. Okay, we'll bring out this boy over here. Happy New Year, happy 1 year, senior logs. Why, thank you, PP9009. Whoa, PP never ever donates bits. That's rare for PP. Even though PP is one of the longest sub people on this channel. He's been watching me since the very beginning. You got to see Ame's new horse model? That's cursed, though. I'd love to say, but I really wasted and I have to go to work 6 hours. See you later, Delta. Okay. I was too poor to sub at the moment. Yeah, true. I can relate. Because I'm running out of money very quickly. Summon out Chandelier from the deck. In defense position? Fuck, I didn't know it was going to be in defense position. Is YouTube stream never coming back? No, it will. Just like, not at the moment. In order to do the YouTube stream, I need to, like, have some semblance of a schedule. and I'm just not mentally prepared to do that yet. I'm still mentally a little bit of a mess. Just a little bit. Oh, I'm trying to think. What was the best thing that happened to me this year? I can't think of anything. What was the single best thing that happened this year? Nothing. This year sucked. You became cool and mysterious. How are you losing money? My Pokemon channel and D&D channel are money holes. You did find a ton of people? Yeah, I guess. But, like, making all those connections has just been very stressful. I sometimes fantasize about deleting my Discord. Because I don't have to talk to anyone anymore. Whenever I get a notification, I get stressed out. I was like, oh no, what is it this time? Because I know too many people. I talk to way too many people. And I have, like, DMs turned off. And even then, it's still stressful. Like, you know, 99% of the time, the DM is totally, like, harmless. There's nothing wrong with it. But it still stresses me out anyway. Do I attempt to be a VTuber? I'm not a VTuber, and that was last year. I technically started in 2021. Can't you mute your Discord notifications? I do have them muted. It's just like I see a big old number and I'm like, oh no. I go through phases though. I'm not always like that. You drew three garnets? No, Metal Zoa's not a garnet. Metal Zoas are. This is terrible. These have to be in the fucking deck. You've got to be kidding me. They're actually dead in the hand. And I only have the two. Happy Nude Bears. Happy New Year's. Oh, thanks for the hype train. I haven't had one of those in a while. I remember back when I used to do this before I had my breakdown. I would have a hype train at the start of every single stream. I grew complacent. Discard fodder, no trading. Anyways, question number two. What was the single most challenging thing that had happened this year? Only one? I can only pick a single thing that was challenging that happened to me. I'd have to say, out of everything, if I were to pick only a single bad thing, or I guess it's just the most challenging thing, it would be starting the MTG channel and the Pokemon channel back to back. That was dumb. I don't know why I did that. I should have just did one of them, waited for it to be successful, and then started the next one. And I hadn't succeeded with the Hearthstone channel, and I still hadn't succeeded with the D&D channel. I was like, hey, I have two channels that aren't successful. And I'm currently working on four of them. Why don't I add two more? Hell yeah. We want extra stress. The MTG channel is doing good. It is almost profitable. It is so close to being profitable. It's almost not a money hole anymore. It's so ridiculously close. Pokemon channel is still too new though. But it's doing good for a brand new channel. The D&D channel is nothing but problems. And I'm losing so much money. Luckily, the WoW channel and the Yu-Gi-Oh! Channels profit city. They're carrying my deficits so hard. What makes a channel profitable or not? If a channel is able to get more money than I spend on scripts and editors, then it makes profit. So far, only the Yu-Gi-Oh! Channel, the D&D channel... No, the Yu-Gi-Oh! And WoW channels do that. However, the Magic channel is very close. It's Ashy! Ashy, we were playing Heroes of the Storm yesterday. You remember playing Heroes of the Storm yesterday? I remember. Ashy raid. Select a card to destroy on the field. Let's destroy Flew Under Reason Impen. Idiot. Idiot moron. Let's see. Lovely play, VRAM. I love it. Ulnar Raid. Is that the Oldner? Oh my god, look at this freaking hand. What deck should I use as a new player? Eldritch. Select a card to add from your deck to your hand. Okay. Uh-oh, are they going to start comboing off? Pop off, queen. Yeah, this is our deck. Can we get a shout out for Ashy of Heart? Do we have any mods on right now? I don't think I've seen any of the mods. We do. We have a flush of VIPs in chat. But I don't see any... Oh, there's PP. I don't know if PP knows how to do it, though. An anonymous gifter is giving you a tier 1 sub to Alpha Beta TV. I don't know who that is. Mod check. Oh, there they are. Lox doesn't know his own mods. Oh yeah, I can just check the room. Users in chat. Moderators, we have PP and Stardust. And that's it. I gotta open up mod applications. And we have Stardust. Stardust Synchron. Okay. Fluunderese. I should probably use Chandelier to set Welcome Labyrinth so I can start popping some stuff. Activate Chandelier. I made Gookin ships with Box of Friends. It's kind of funny to combo off with. Wait, is it all zero? Featherstorm? This will still resolve, right? Oh, god damn it. Seriously? All you do is make predictions and occasionally tell chat to chill out. Yeah, I need some stuff. Mods are 500 pounds. Yeah. Happy New Year's for the East Coast. Happy New Year's, Crypto 406. How's it crack-a-lackin'? Logs needs a secretary. I do have a secretary. Box of Friends is zero defense monster. So Sioux ships. I didn't know Sioux ships were zero defense. I thought maybe they had like 100 defense or something. Being a mod is not stressful at all. Hee hee. I've always wanted to do this. Sniff feet. Did he just flip one of my cards face down? Man, that full monster negate of Harpy's Featherstorm is redunculous. Whenever I do make predictions, people put up broke numbers. Let's see. Wait, was this my turn? That was all during my turn? Wait, if they had Harpy's Featherstorm, why didn't they use it earlier? Oh, I guess I removed their card from the field last time. Oh my god, I can't believe that was all during their turn. Yep, gotta love Flu. I thought that was their turn. I thought I was like, oh, it's almost my turn. I can do something now. Okay, this deck is not good enough to deal with this. You have got to be kidding me, right meow. What's this next question? What was an unexpected joy of this past year? An unexpected joy? I wasn't expecting to discover that I like certain voices. Ow. Flu. You've got two dead cards in hand. This is probably would be different if you're able to do something. I do have two dead cards in hand. And all my effects are negated. Why does Flu have so many good cards? They didn't even use Dimension Fissure. Let's see. What was an unexpected obstacle of the past year? An unexpected obstacle. None. Everything was easy. Ooh, another MPEM. Nice. I really didn't pay attention to the duel. I should have quit out a while ago. Let me quit out. I don't want to watch their chains go off. Can we watch Yu-Gi-Oh 5D today? We missed a couple of Saturdays. No. Let's see here. I didn't get to play this one yet. This one is great. You should have the flu coop. I'm looking through all of my New Year's questions for the past year. Pick three words that describe this past year. Holy stall. Yeah, this deck tries to stall. It's pretty bad at it. It's not the best at stalling, to be honest. Okay, we can use Pot of Duality, three words, life point, gain mill. They're gonna use Chandelier on me. All right, if you say so. Will I pull a second Overroot? I have three Overroots. What card did they pick? I wasn't paying attention. Astro Karibo. Oh, I can't special summon this turn. They pitched a Gamma. Maybe they have another Gamma in their hand. Who knows? End phase. I'm too poor to pull Pax logs. Welcome Labyrinth. Okie dokie. Jet Dragon low key cracked versus Labyrinth. Is it? They don't really like destroy a lot though, do they? Okay, Ariana of the Labyrinth is gonna search out another card from their deck. Searching out Lovely Castle. Ooh, the castles are gonna be annoying. They can use that to pop my floodgates. But if they pop my cards, then my Jet Dragon's gonna come out. Oh my god, do they seriously just summon a single time? Oh my god, they're not even going to attack. You absolute buffoon. Two. Three. Four. Happy New Year's, Mr. Logs. Happy New Year, Mr. Logs. I'm trying to think, what three words describe this past year? Great, amazing, wonderful. Let's go into Shirai, the ominous omen. The ominous omen. The ominous omen. Shirai, the ominous omen. Activate Shirai, the ominous omen. Yeah, it's Shirai time. Welcome, Labyrinth. Uh-oh. And a ghastly glitch. Uh-oh. They're gonna proc my Jet Dragon. Okay. The ominous omen. Labyrinth comes out. He's throwing everything because Shirai has no target. True, that is true. Shirai has no targets. That face down card is probably more dangerous than anything. Let's get rid of this one. Oh, it was just Magic Cylinder. Literally nothing to worry about. If you activate a non-Labyrinth normal trap card, special summon a card from your graveyard. Oh, and then they get another summon card. Whoa. Oh, and then Chandelier in the graveyard. Oh, and welcome Labyrinth. Your turn, our turn. No, it's fine. I got this. They can't do anything this turn. They're completely out of options. All they're doing is reloading their resources for next turn. Unless they drew into a really good fiend monster, like a barrier statue. Which they did not, you absolute buffoon. Okay, now I have Jet Dragon live. The Labyrinth player be popping off. That's what you think. Oh, then it's going to use its effect immediately. Okay. Just what casual plus three, wait till tier. To set Labyrinth Barrage, which can't be used this turn. Let's say I have Cuckoo Clock in hand. Activate Astral Karibo, reveal Fortune Tune for a level 3. Flip summon this card, and then we go into Fortune Tune. Can't be targeted or destroyed by battle or card effects. Get absolutely shenanigade. Okay, and then we'll just start destroying. Start the damage step. This card battles. Target one card opponent controls. Return it to the hand. Oh yeah, we can do this to get rid of both of them. Which one of these was Welcome Labyrinth? I think it might have been this one. Okay. I thought it was going to be Zeus. I mean, I could go into Zeus, but this is better. Because he can't be targeted or destroyed by battle or card effects. He is completely immune to everything. I think the only way my opponent can out this card is if they have, specifically Ice Dragon's Prison. Or if they somehow have a way to go into Zeus. So a crooked cook, but worse? Yeah. It's not completely immune to card effects, but it is very hard to get rid of. And I gain life points every turn. Ooh, 500 life points. Yes, please. If they destroy my Spirit Reaper, then I get Jet Dragon back. Welcome, Labyrinth. Life point gain mill found. Exactly. Labyrinth Barrage. Wait, someone's actually using Labyrinth Barrage? And a Compulse. Alright. Maybe they were trying to send back my my Fortune Tune. Oh no, they're sending back the other card because that will allow them to proc their Labyrinth effects. In order to... Oh no, if they bring out a Labyrinth Mommy. Oh, thank God they only played one. That means they can't pop a card in my hand. Never mind. No. Please, I need my Lava Golem. Don't fuck me. Don't pop the card in my hand. I need that Lava Golem. Jet protects the set Reaper. Yeah. I need to get one of these cards on the field. All of their Labyrinth cards. Well, at the very least, they can't out my Fortune Tune, even if they do pop the card in my hand. Ooh, another lovely lady of the Silver Castle. It's my turn. I'll do this one and pop these two. And then they immediately use the effect. How many cards do they have in their deck? Traded two monsters for one. What a deal! Well, the main purpose of that is to make sure they have... They start losing life points. Although, I don't know if I can do that, because they can pop everything on my field except for this Fortune Tune. However, with how much they're searching from their deck, they'll probably deck themselves out. Oh wait, they also have... Underworld Goddess is an out to it. Damn, they're just like clicking buttons, don't they? Welcome Labyrinth before even flipping up their field spell. So we're just stalling? Yeah, the whole point of this deck is to stall. My opponent just keeps clicking buttons though. They have so many plays for days. Button smasher clicker. There was no reason for them to do that all during their draw phase. Yeah, discarded Fusion Destiny. Mm-hmm. Not that it would have worked. Labyrinth ran Accumulated Fortune. It's crazy. It doesn't work. It's immune to destruction. You absolute buffoon. Oh, they don't have any traps. Nightmare Wheel! Gained 500 life points every turn. Hell yeah. End phase. Nightmare is during the standby phases, right? So I need to do this during the draw phase. So they lose an extra 500 life points. Nightmare is such a throwback card. I know, right? Is it during the standby phase? During your standby phase. Oh no. Oh my god, they love clicking buttons. Oh, you want to leave? Okay. To be fair, he used Astro Karibo. Yeah, he's currently extra immune to destruction.
Here.
No Underworld Goddess? Appalooza? Your point is activate the effect of a card. Or card effect. Did they destroy something? Oh, I guess Nightmare Wheel got destroyed, technically. The trap. Oh my god, I didn't think it worked that way. May time? Alright, here you go. Happy New Year's? Yes, Happy New Year's. It can only activate when a set card is revealed. Yeah, Apple does nothing for them. Yeah, that's surprising. If they had Underworld Goddess, they could have outed this card. Look at them attacking uselessly. They don't even know that they've already lost. All they do is just wait. I bet he's going to put Underworld Goddess in now. Yep. I'm going to gain so many life points. They're going to try to negate it. All right. Greetings. Ooh, Soul of the Supreme King. That's a good one. Okay. Negating a 500 life point gain, genius. It is. I literally have never seen anything smarter before in my life. Let's summon out this card. How much you want to bet he's going to try and negate the effect? It activates. What are you going to do? Yep, I knew it. You absolute buffoon. The effect is already negated and Appalooza doesn't even destroy. Get negated. Wait, if I have evac device, does that mean the effect will still go off? Anaconda. Oh. Certified button clicker. Yeah, literally just clicking buttons. Let me see. Match history. Yeah, they pitched Destiny. I forgot about that. Why did they get rid of Psyframe Gear Gamma? Basically, as soon as they could, if there was a card effect that was glowing up for them, they would click it. Without even thinking about it. You didn't have Driver? Oh my god, that's so funny. There's no Driver. Gamma, but no Driver. Literally an unusable hand trap. No wonder he pitched it. Probably right in his stream review. Let's play Snipe Hunter Control. I adjusted the deck to be a little bit better. Let's see, next question. Pick three words your partner or close friend would use to describe your year. Terrible. Pick three words your partner or close friend would use to describe their year. Probably all right. Snipe Hunter, what is this, 2006? Yeah, it's Snipe Hunter Control. It's the best deck I have, and oh my god, I drew terribly. Boring. What was the best book you read this year? The Sylvanas novel, that was pretty good. Who were your most valuable relationships with? out of all of my YouTuber friends, out of all of my streamer friends, which one of them was the most valuable? If we were to rank them. How do you rank something that is most valuable? It's Branded Fusion? Whatever. Twitch chat? I don't read books, only novels. It's the same thing. Brain Dead Fusion. What was the question again? What was the most valuable relationship with? Who were your most valuable relationships with? Definitely everyone in chat. Yeah. Because we don't have any parasocial relationships here. Just tons of best friends. What was your biggest personal change from January to December of this past year? My biggest personal change? I've definitely gotten a lot more unhinged. In what ways did you grow emotionally? Ooh, I've gotten really good at ignoring my problems. In what way did you grow spiritually? In what ways did you grow physically? I'm a lot stronger now than I was. Activate. Dice Spoon. Oh my god, double dragon. Still ignoring your problems? Of course I'm ignoring my problems. I'm a problem ignorer, enjoyer. This is a hard ones per turn, right? Can I go into... I can. Duolong's the American Psycho Transformation. What? Do they have dragon monsters, fiend monsters in the graveyard? Dragon, fairy, dragon... Nope. Wow. Double Masquerade Dragon. Are you going to be a VTuber in 2023? No. First, Masquerade. Terrors of Overroot. Select a card to send to the graveyard. Select a card in the graveyard to give to them. We can give them... It sets the card, so they can't use it. Terrors of Overroot. And then... We'll activate this card. Albaz is a dragon. Yeah, but they're fiends. So it doesn't matter. Ice Dragon's Prison into defense position. Terrors of Overroot. Select a card for Fallen of Albaz to be set to the field. A flip summon doesn't count as a normal summon, right? If a fusion monster you control sent to the graveyard, bring this card up. Can't read. Tax Dragon is a fiend? Yeah. Okay, it's still my opponent's turn, right? Yeah, it's my opponent's turn. They activated Harpy's Feather Duster. Now they're thinking about what to do next. In what ways did you grow in your relationships with others? I made too many new connections. Now I know too many people and it stresses me out. That's going on a Millennium Era quest and Masquerade Dragon is a fiend? Yeah. Pog, new friends. What was the most enjoyable part of your work, both professionally and at home? Dude, sometimes I forget that my job is awesome. I literally just make like YouTube videos for a living. The streams are something I do extra on the side. I'm just as mind blown when I learned Mirror Jade is a worm. Ooh, Predator Plant Verte Anaconda. I can't wait for Lord of Thorny Dragons to be a plant monster. I really need to go first with this deck, and also draw one of my mini floodgates. If I don't, then I'm ham-boned. And I can't control my opponent's board. My job would be awesome if I got paid decently. What do you do for a living? You have grown by finding people to scratch your masochistic itch. I wish. Ooh, do they use Super Poly to attack directly? I was gonna lose either way. Masquerade Labyrinth deck time? Ooh, that's a good idea. Add Dimension Shifter if you go second. That is a good idea. I'll just hope I go first. What do you do for a living? TikTok vibes? Yeah, what do you do for a living? First, I work at a small company, so even if they wanted to pay me more, the money isn't there, and I haven't gotten a new interview in months. Oh, I own a small company. I get it.
Need more going second cards?
I need to draw specifically into my floodgates, which I did not draw into. I am once again ham-boned. I have a solution. Rob a bank. Okay. Nothing. None of my floodgates. Has the new YouTube demonetization rules messed with your videos at all? No, it has not. I don't custom my videos. Ham bone with emotes. Ooh, a ham bone emote. That's a good idea. Let's see. What was the most challenging part of your work, both professionally and at home? Definitely starting two extra channels this year. Technically, I started four channels this year. Why did I do that? I started four new channels this year. There was the D&D, not the D&D, the Duel Logs. There was the Hearthstone channel, the Magic channel, and the Pokemon channel. And that was four too many. I was already overworked when I still had the just original three. I'm not sure why I did that. Damn it, I'm going against nothing but meta decks right now. I freaking hate rank reset. Thanks for the sub, man goated. The Duel Log started last year? Yeah, I started at the end of 2021. Yep, that'd be the issue of rank resets. Yeah. Silver is actually pretty sweaty, just at the beginning of a new rank reset.
Huh.
I thought this would be an easy. Nope. Got full sweat. Give it a week. Silver will feel like silver. Yeah, I know, but like, it just reset today. Maybe he's playing Angel of Mischief FTK? There's no way.
That would be convenient if they were.
Recital Starling number 2. The Ghastly Glitch. Hello, I'm too lazy to say dual logs a million times this time. No way. You call me worthless? Yammy, you're worthless. You piece of garbage. I hope you have a bad year. There it is, utopic future. Now we can get rid of it. And then we'll just give him this card back. Whew. I didn't hit any normal monsters. And now they have the Kuraz cards. Oh my god, this is so annoying. Not my opponent. I know he was going to do that. I just like being having to constantly click off my backjack because I can't use it. Hi, Mr. Dual Logs. Here in my home, I have 10 minutes of the year left. It's only 10 more minutes until your New Year's? I have an hour and 10 minutes. Oh my god. Does the dual logs have drip? No. Barrel Canary, oh my god, can you stop? Why do Manifold's Fusion the deck? Seems like such a brick to add for a deck that doesn't discard much. Oh, this deck discards a shit ton. That's why it's in there. The no drip logs. Oh, immediately attacking with their lowest attack monster, so I have to use it. Is this going to be a countdown stream? No. They're going for a Zeus too? Oh, I guess that is a pretty beefy Zeus, isn't it? Oh my god, this backjack is so annoying. Is he finally done? We can count the life points. A Zeus, a four material Zeus. Zeus isn't once per turn, is it? Nope. That's why you wanted to have four materials so you can use it twice to avoid negates. Look, I have Snipe Hunter. Time to hit this Divine Arsenal double A Zeus. They're gonna let it go through? Ooh. Is this Snipe Hunter control? Yes. What circumstances do you find yourself discarding Herald of Arclight? Oh my god, they let it go through. They don't want to out their field. Seriously, I whiffed twice? That's a 2/3 chance of success. That's a 2/3 chance of success. Actual protagonist moment. My opponent's dex. It's always 50%. Either it happens or it doesn't. It's 2/3. It's not 50%. Do-do-do-do. Okay. Triple that. Oh, here we go. Okay, what are some other good hand traps? The next best ones. Effect Veiler is not half bad. Good job, deck 5. Okay. Oh yeah, the new Flirtalist is good. Solemn Judgment? No, I need going second cards. Solemn Judgment, unfortunately. I mean, going first cards. I know I have a and D Slayer, but just trust me. It's there for a reason. Vespa. Zeus. Okay. Time for deck 5 to perform. Feather Duster? I don't need Feather Duster. But you're right, I probably should have some kind of back row. Your opponent is deciding whether to go first or second? I don't care if I go first or second. No response from the game server? Mr. Logs, how are you feeling? What do you mean? Just use Final Destiny? Oh, I probably should. What was the single biggest time waster in your life this past year? Streaming. That was easy. I don't think I've wasted more time doing anything else than streaming. Oh, fuck. This sucks. Holy shit. All the hand traps and none of the starters? Well, at least they're all unique hand traps. Mr. Logs, what did you get chat for Christmas? Nothing. You guys know how much time I spent streaming this year? A lot. Mythical institution. At least no driver? That's true. Drawn into a driver would have sucked. Chicken game to draw a card. More than 1 hour? I think like half of my work hours were streaming. Oh no, it's Magic Boy. They drew into another one? Terraforming? Now they can't draw into another one. You absolute buffoon. Ghostbound, Ash Blossom chatting together. Into the Void? Why are they drawing so many cards? Are they just trying to get spell counters? Let's see. What was the best way you used your time in the past year? All the best uses of my time was when I was just like organizing things and hiring people. What was the biggest thing you learned this past year? The biggest thing I learned? Oh, I know what I learned. It's 1 minute to my new year, Mr. Logs. I hope 2023 will be another amazing year with your streams. Have a lovely night. You're my best Oshi that's not a VTuber. Why, thank you, machine. I'm not a VTuber, though. What was I talking about again? I got distracted by a wholesome message. What was the biggest thing you learned in this past year? I learned that people don't always mean what they say. And I was like, whoa, no shit. Finally! The first time they've activated a goddamn fucking spell card, all gosh darn monster, all gosh darn game. Secret village? Okay, idiot. Battle phase. Pomu. I learned dual logs is a oh my god, seriously? He just locked himself out? I mean, if he summons a spellcaster, then he's no longer locked out. Oh my god. Only hand traps? This is what I get for playing 20 hand traps. Hand trap control. Give me one of my cards. Endmaster, Magister, Endymion. He summoned a monster. He can use spell cards now. Ooh, I can use spell cards too. Psyframe Gear Gamma. Watch them rage quit? Oh my god, that would save me so much time. Do 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 do. Burr, 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 burr. Create a phrase or statement that describes this past year for you. Ooh, I love retro. I love looking back at my years. Branded in high spirits. I wouldn't even be able to use this even if I could. Hi, what did I miss? Nothing. I'm just bricking by drawing none of my usable monsters and just hand traps. Did they just lock their scales? It looks like it. Nothing like a top deck war. Oh my god. Nice house with all these bricks. Hey, thanks. Silver duels. Silver duels on rank reset. Thanks for the prime sub, Lairmashu. Oh, it was a new year for some of you people. 3 minutes ago. Teodor Savrak, Electromite. If they go into Electromite, I can just negate his effects. And then maybe I can draw into something on my next turn. I got 2 hours left. Excellent. I only have 1 hour left before it's the new year. Oh. Okay, get crunked, idiot. Even though I haven't drawn anything usable in the past 8 turns. Gunshots? You guys can hear gunshots? Ooh, I can bring this card out. Or I can bring out Spriggan's kit. Celebrated 6 hours ago? Excellent. Special summon Spriggan's kit. Activate Spriggan's kit. Add a branded spell from your graveyard to your hand. And then reset your garnets. Are those gunshots? No, they're not gunshots. They're people setting off fireworks. They're just having a blast with their fireworks. You know how it is. Activate Sprint, the Iron Dasher. Summon Rocky to the field? Yes. Activate Rocky's effect to add Branga back to the hand. Why are people shooting you here? It's fireworks. The people around here fucking love fireworks. At least you know the dogs didn't where to freak out the fireworks. Oh no, they're here. One of my biggest dogs is right underneath my desk. So I'm in a very uncomfortable position because he won't leave. And he's way too big to be underneath the desk. Nah, it's shots. No, it's fireworks. Mate time! Questions for kids. Wow, excellent questions for the new year. 24 family conversation starters for the New Year's? Hell yeah, I want to see 24 conversation starters for the New Year's. Ooh, Celine, the Queen of Master Magicians. I can negate this with Ghost Spell. Nah, I think you're cooked. Shut the hell up. New Year's conversation starters. Name one thing you've tried this year. Ooh, something you tried this year. I tried traveling. Pick 3 words to describe your year. Favorite place you visited this year. Favorite place I visited this year. I don't like leaving my house. Have you considered getting a crate or something for the dog so it can feel like it's in a safe spot? Does that work? What is the most important lesson you learned this year? Draw 2 cards was selected. Oh my god, you stupid bitch. You resolved a triple tactics talent versus me? My favorite place to visit was Las Vegas. Ooh, Las Vegas sounds fun. I should go there. What is your favorite card from the past year? What's an important lesson you learned? My dog loves her crate, just stays in it with the door open. Really? If this guy doesn't close up the game this turn, I'm gonna be real sad. Damn, he really popped off this game. 2 End of Beyonds? Into an absolute dragon with them. Here, let's just... They're running out of time? You think they'll run out of time? Here, I'll wait to see if they run out of time. I don't think they will, because I think they have more than enough time to do stuff. Absolute Dragon into IP Mascarina. I fucking bricked for 10 turns. How do you brick for 10 turns? Did you get the Totally Awesome mate? No, I don't like Totally Awesome. Maytime again? I don't know why you guys like Maytime so much. This is just Sulfacore turn one at this point. They've finally popped off. I wish I could see how much time my opponent had. That would be awesome. I found someone in HOTS that has a level of over 2k. Really? Whoa. Mate looks better than the art. I didn't know if that was possible. You know what sounds fun is if I go over to the secret stream and just play a whole bunch of random games. Aren't you like dead? Yeah, but my opponent might run out of time. I have a Totally Awesome on my desk right now and you made it sad? Good. The secret logs. What's the secret stream? There it is. Battle phase. Now they have to go very fastly, otherwise I win. I did not win. I bricked for 10 turns. No, like, yeah, half my deck is my actual engine. I just only drew into my hand traps for 10 turns. Not so secret anymore, I know. Hazukashi. Going first. Excellent. Would an engines only deck work? When Halky Fibrax was still around, it was called a 60 card pile. Yeah, it does. Add the Great Sansi Golgonda to your hand. I can normal summon Spriggan's Kit in order to add a branded spell trap from my deck to the hand. And then I can reset Ferdelius. And then... Oh, I can't use it. And then lose because I don't have any follow-up plays. I forgot I can't summon this card unless I have a card in the field. Hopefully why doesn't have anything good. What was the most embarrassing moment of the year? What was the best advice you received this year? Dude, I don't remember anything about the year. What is one event that had a big impact on you? I have no idea. What was your favorite song of the year? Oh my god. Guys, after my stream earlier today, Miawi sent me like another cover she sang. I can't remember if she told me if I can play it or not. But I'm gonna play it anyway.
You know, I really contemplated singing the song with my karaoke mic, but I decided maybe I shouldn't.
Junk Synchron. Thanks for the sub, Sea Goblin. I haven't seen you since last year. It's still the last year. Darda Synchron.
Hold me without touch.
Arrive in the light.
Keep me without change.
Wow, they have so much gas. Where's all the hand traps I had last game? Give me one of my hand traps, please. I'm begging you. I made a mistake. Omni Brotar.
I don't wanna fall in love this moment.
5 cards from the deck. Only 4? Wow. Just the way I'm supposed to be. You're on to me. I'll give you guys a link to it. Ah, yes. Only 4 from the deck. He could have summoned 5. The absolute buffoon, the moron, who's about to go into a Baron-dipped lure. Guys, I'm hamboned. I made a mistake. Haven't seen you stream since last year. I already read that, didn't I? The optimal version only plays 3 summons, actually? Really? Wait, why'd they increase its level to 10? They're trying to go into a level 11? Shooting Star Majestic Dragon? 1 Majestic Dragon plus 1 non-tuner monster, including a Dragon Synchro monster. Oh, I guess now they can go into Barandia floor with its graveyard effect. Celestial Dragon? You can special summon up to 4 level 2 non-tuner monsters from your hand or graveyard in defense position. Oh my god, he's comboing off. Quick Draw is the only other thing you can summon. Oh yeah, level 5, I guess. Can they only summon 1 card for that? He has full combo. What's his full combo? He's going fast and it makes him feel alive. TG Hyper Librarian. Uh-oh, can he continue from here? Oh yeah, I guess Jet Synchro can come back. He also has Assault Mode too. He's clearing his mind. They go into Garden Rose Maiden. TG Hyper Librarian to draw a card. His mind is so damn clear right now. Cosmic Blazar Dragon. What does this one do? Once per turn, you can negate the effects of 1 effect monster your opponent controls. Special summon a tuner monster from your hand. He already has lethal. I don't know if he can really combo any more from here. The kit is too powerful. I could have stopped all this. The only thing that would make his mind clear is a synchro using Majestic and the Quasar. I don't think he can. Yeah, now they can go into Baron if they want. There's Baron. I was waiting for Baron the whole time. Excellent. Good show. How many times have I lost in a row? 4 times. The deck isn't performing that bad. The first time I just drew really badly. The second time I actually just misplayed. I could have won. I'll be right back. Hello, it's me, the Duologues. I'm a spider from the moon. This is a public service announcement in order to address some slander I've been seeing in chat. I've seen lots of people say that I'm from Jupiter, which is not true. Okay, now that we have that out of the way, let's go into this ad, because I'm probably playing this while I'm gone. How to make friends. I get this one a lot in chat. You know, those people say, hey, the Duologues, I don't have any friends. How do I make friends? And I say, well, why are you asking me? Like, I play Yu-Gi-Oh! For a living. You think I have friends? So anyways, let's go over some tips on how to make friends. Now, first step, the number one step, be the initiator. Don't wait for people to contact you. Have you ever watched a TV show or an anime where the main character is some dweeb, some loser, some absolute just nobody who does nothing? He has no skills, and yet he gets all these friends and things. You know, usually what happens is that other people reach out to him, and he doesn't have to do anything. Don't be that person. Be the side character. Be the side person who reaches out to the main character and forces them in all those adventures. That's how you do it. Waiting for things to happen is guaranteeing that they won't, unless you get lucky. And you probably won't. Also, when you talk to people, don't look for the right things to say. Just say what you like or dislike. I know this. Guys, I'm back. Deck 5. I can do this. Duolong doesn't even know BBTV exists. No, I know it exists. I just don't care about it. When you'll gain a rank? Excellent. Hi, Dad. I'm back. Hello there. Oh, my desktop audio is still very high. I was thinking, what if I just look back through my year? And think about everything that happened this year. But if I do that while dueling, I'm gonna get distracted. It seems like something I would have to go over to the secret stream to do. Can mods do applications? The Spriggan's booty? You should just join a trust strategy stream where you watch YouTube videos? That's a good idea. Because rank is really sweaty right now, so I can't play any of my fun decks. Oh no! Rank reset week is rough, especially when my decks are bad. Let's summon this card. Indecisive Battle of Gungolda, good. What's that? Man, seriously, Ash Merrymaker? He sure did. I wish he hadn't. What does this one do? What is your most successful fun deck? Probably Comic Hand Control. Because it just runs a bunch of floodgates and steals my opponent's cards. Predictions. Can we do mods, please? I don't know. Can we do them? Can we do predictions, mods? Isn't there a Triple Tactics Towns retrain that can search for any spell card? There is, but it's not in the game yet. Unexpected die. Can we have mods? I don't know. Can you have mods? It keeps asking me to use my cards. I don't want to. Oh, god damn it. It's Sue Ships. Playing against Pendulum, the worst possible experience in Yu-Gi-Oh! True. Gukon, Sue Ships. Yeah, let's destroy it. Now they can't do anything. Yeah, base deck. Based on what? Decisive Battle Golgonda is a continuous spell that's name becomes the same as the field spell that protects your cards from destruction, sending fusion monsters from the graveyard. Destruction, sending Albat's fusions to the grave. Wait, Decisive Battle? It becomes the same name, but does it have the same effect? Also, it's not a Master Duel yet. It's based on food? Happy New Year, Spider in chat. Yes, Happy New Year. Doop-ba-doop-ba-doo, boop-ba-doop-ba-doo. Dreadnought. Oh, he's going to try to tack over my card and then go into something big. Wait, how do you get another one out? I wasn't paying attention. The battle phase is going. He's going for an attack. I can use Spriggan's Merrymaker to dodge. And then activate both of these cards to stop it. And then what does this one do? Can I attack for the rest of this turn? Wait, what does this one do? He normaled the Shari Red. Oh. Either way, he can't attack this turn. It's all good. As long as I draw into a Spriggan's card, I'll be good to go. I think this is good. Activate Spriggan's Watch. Send a Spriggan's card from the deck to the graveyard. Reveal 3 Gukon ships. Put Mask Chameleons and Dinomorphs? No. That doesn't sound fun for your opponent. I don't even know what they're doing. When you activate this card, you can also reveal a Gukon Suship Shari in your hand. Okay, whatever. Select a card to add from your deck to your hand. Select a card to send from your deck to the graveyard. Okay. Ooh, I can use Branded in High Spirits. On my Spriggan's Brothers. To send Sprint to the graveyard. Send this card. Ooh, I can search out Fallen of Albaz, the Ashen. Then I can activate Spriggan's Brothers to bring back Rocky. Use Rocky to add Brothers back to my hand. Okay. It's in defense position, huh? Then normal summon this card with 2400 attack. Put this card into attack position. Activate Spriggan's Brang. Attach it to this card over here. Okay. Uh-oh, I didn't mean to do that. This card gains 200 attack for each monster in your graveyard. Wait, how come he wasn't destroyed? Oh my god. Seriously? Oh no. Smart. I'm trying my best, okay? Now they can rank him up. Watch out, he has sharp ice. I forgot how the card worked. Super Dreadnought Rail Cannon. Oh, they didn't go into like one of the immune boss monsters. This deck was made for misplay. Shut up. Never mind, more based on what? You have got to be kidding me, right, meow? Can't I still go into Zeus? Yeah, I can still go into Zeus. Activate Spriggan's Brain. Oh, fuck, I didn't mean to do that effect. Yeah, you have got to be kidding me, right, meow? Ban Zeus TBH. Do I even have rank 4s in the deck? Not really. Okay, we'll just put a bunch of cards on him. Activate Spriggan's Brothers. Okay, and then we'll activate Ship. I wish I'd put it on this zone over here. Infinite Impermanence. Alrighty then. His effect is negated. Cool. I guess we can go into Zeus. And not worry about other kinds of cards and effects. Activate the effect of Sprint? Yes. We'll add Pidor to my hand. So I saw some like lore on this card. Apparently this card is named after Torpedo. It's supposed to be Spriggan's Torpedo, but they didn't want to call it Spriggan's Torpedo for some reason. So they shortened it. They got rid of the Tor from it. So it was just the second half of it. And his name was Pedo. So they added an R to it. So it's Pidor, which itself is a Russian curse word. They should have just called it Torpedo. Pidor. Got his name after he met Kit. Nice save, Konami. Yep. Good job, Torpedor. Yeah, his name is Torpedor. Ah, oh, yes, Spriggan's based on grace. The poor kid's mindset. Your opponent is about to end his or her turn. Activate the effect of a card. Not quite yet. I guess now we can do it. Get rid of all the cards on the field. Rocket vibes. Maximum C, huh? What if I just win this turn? Did you ever think of that? All of the cards are gone now. This card is in attack position. Special summons Spriggan's Kit to attack position. Dogmat. Wait, why didn't they just use that earlier? Oh, they can't even use this effect because there's not another Dogmatica card on the field. Oh no, they're trying to block out my FTK. Add a card from your deck to your hand. I don't really need to because I'm just going to put it back in the deck. Because the cards in hand are better. Normal summon. Pidor. Special summon. Tribute this card. Special summon Rocky. In attack position. Activate Rocky's effect. To add... Oh, I can add that card back to my hand? Ooh, I think I'd rather just have Pidor. Pidor, like Torpedo. Okay. Special summon, activate Ecclesia. Search out Flirtilis. Special summon Flirtilis. Whoa, look at all this gas. No cards on the field. Battle phase. I did it. Yeah, summon the... No, the torpedo. It's a torpedo. Hopefully they don't have gores in their hand. .500 overkill. I did it. I finally won a match with this card. Victory. Okay. Floor delicious. Oh my god, these dogs. They're in the way. They're such in the way. Return to the main menu. Cool loot. Give me a second. Stay calm and relax and enjoy the show. Let's do year-end review. Nine days. Do you guys want to walk with me through my past year on this platform? A year-end review. Studio mode. Let's come over here. I think this is good. We can hold hands together. Let me turn on some nice fire music, some background music, and then we'll come over here. Here it is. This is where it all started. The first channel, Rumor Red X. We don't need to talk about this. I want to see how many videos did I release in the past year. We'll go back to 1 year. We'll count this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 rows. 4 times 9. Is that 28? 4 times 9. No, it's 36. 36 videos. Let me write that down. 36 videos. Okay. Isn't easy to check in studio mode? Yeah. I'm not going into studio mode though. How many videos did I release over here? This is not including whatchamacallit. This is not including shorts. Ah, here we go. The 1 year mark. I remember these ones were released at the very end of the year because they didn't do very well. We'll just include this entire row because these were also released towards the end of the year. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, and 32. 32 times 4. 128 videos. WoW equals 36. Yu-Gi-Oh! Equals 128. Holy moly. Only 128 videos. That is so many videos. You want to know something funny? This main channel. Alright, I don't have a button for this. This main channel right here, the Haruma Red X. This channel has 5 staff members who work on it. There's 6 of them now. We have 5 people who work on this channel. That is 3 editors, a script writer, and a person who sets the videos up. On this channel over here, for the longest time, we had 1 staff member who was just an editor, and I would just do the scripts. And that was it. Recently, we've hired more script writers and more editors. And that was only till like half the year, like 36 videos in a year. With 5 staff members versus 128 with like half of those just being literally just one person. 3 videos a month. Don't forget the clip channels. Clip channel is like superfluous. That's something else. Something else completely. Crazy thing. So what happened was on the World of Warcraft channel, there was this big old controversy with Blizzard. They got into some big troubles. And what happened was I didn't tell them anything. A lot of content creators decided to stop covering Blizzard content, and they went back to it eventually. And I was like, you know, I'm not going to stop covering Blizzard content. I'm not going to stop covering World of Warcraft because I like World of Warcraft. So what I did instead was like, I'm going to double down on this and I'm going to hire more people. I hired more editors. I hired someone who works with the editors. I hired script writers. I was like, I'm going to go all in this. I'm not just going to do it all by myself anymore. Just like 1 or 2 editors. I did have editors at the time. They just weren't really doing anything. And then, after entrusting all of that stuff to new editors, we produced less videos than what I just did by myself. I was like, oh my goodness gracious, this is terrible. How is this so bad? And I spent like a whole year just trying to figure out what did I do wrong. why is it that we added more people to this project and we just are actually producing less videos than when I used to do it by myself? You love to see it. Too many cooks. We kind of solved some of the problems. The other problem is that I'm crazy. when the problem is too hard, I just stop thinking about it. And when I stop thinking about it, I just don't do anything about it. And the problem just gets worse because I ignore the problem. And then it doesn't get fixed. Yeah. So then we have this channel over here. At the beginning of the year, we have this video right here called Yu-Gi-Oh! Player Looks at Magic Cards and Tries to Figure Out if They're Good or Not. So what happened was someone left a comment. They're like, hey, you should take a look at Magic Cards and make a video, see if you can guess if they're good or not. And I remember replying to him, I was like, good idea. That's what I'm going to do. And I did the stream, and I made a clip video for it, and it did super well. It had, look, 500,000 views. That's a ridiculous amount. So obviously I was like, oh, this can be good. Let's do it again for Pokemon cards. Also did well. 250,000 views. I was like, oh, let's do it again for Vanguard cards. Didn't do as well. Vanguard, not as popular. I was like, okay, let's do Magic again. Did even better than the original. Then we looked at Digimon cards. Didn't do very well. However, the Digimon card game, you know, through doing this video because I had to learn how to play the game, I actually found that I really liked the Digimon card game. I just wish they had an online version. And then we did the Dragon Ball Super version. Oh, and then this is when Master Duel came out. Holy shit. And then we did Vanguard again. And then we did Commander cards and Magic. Those ones did well. And then I started streaming more seriously around this time because Master Duel came out and I was like spending more time on streams. And I also did a Hearthstone one, but it's over on the Clip channel. We found it. The log streams too. Wait, what? I don't know what that means. Stevie, what are you doing here? If Digimon gets online version, I'm a Digi-Oh. Dude, I want to play the Digimon card game. The Digimon card game is fun. We are chatting, getting the One Piece logs. Chatting. I should change the category over to just chatting. Because I'm going to be just chatting for a bit. Oh my god, it's your boyfriend, Mr. Duel Logs, Stevie. Psh. I told you guys, it's a bit. I watch like all of Stevie's streams when he's doing his drama stuff. His drama stuff is very... like, he has a very, like, neutral approach to it, which I appreciate. His legs hate you because you are too nice. I don't hate Stevie. He loves drama. He's the drama guy. No, I was telling chat Stevie. And the reason they're all like, hey, Stevie's here. I was telling him, it was like, all of the VTubers I talk to have told me that Stevie is nicer than me. And I was like, that can't be true. Stevie? Of all people? He's nicer than me? So now chat thinks I hate you. Happy New Year, by the way, homie. Yes, Happy New Year. Even though I met my Pokemon channel editor through your stream chat. What, are we wrong? Yes. I tell you guys all the time, you guys are stupid idiots. He doesn't insult us. He's so much nicer than his chat, isn't he? Throw Stevie, that's a lie. I never watch him. Yeah, anyways. Oh, there is one thing weird about Stevie. Stevie really doesn't like Mori Calliope for some reason. Which is just really odd. I don't get that. Anyways, we do not bring up 2017 Mori Calliope lyrics. I mean, she does like rap music. There's probably going to be some sus stuff in there. Anyways. I lost my train of thought. Shut up, we're trying to trick him. / shout out. No, shut up. So... oh yeah, Master Duel. Dude, you guys remember when Master Duel came out? I haven't made a Duel Links video since Master Duel came out. So, like, I was trying new stuff, but I wasn't trying new stuff because I was trying to, like, do new stuff. I just thought it was a cool idea. And despite how samey a lot of my videos are, I do try a lot of, like, new things, just, like, not all on the same channel. Usually it's the World of Warcraft channel where I experiment with the new stuff. Why Duel Links failed? 50% like ratio, 10 trillion views? Did Duel Links fail, though? Like, it used to make them a buttload of money before Master Duel came out. And it probably still does. Oh, the Why It's Banned series. I'm so glad this is done. I hated making this. It was such a pain in the ass to research. Just lie? I don't need to do that. Look at the views I get by just doing my videos like normal. Look at this. 47,000 views. And this is like one of my worst performing videos on the channel. The videos perform... Oh, 38,000. Never mind. This one did way worse. Nice advice. My friends and I bet what cards would be on the next TCG ban list. Any input to help me win? I have no idea. Top 10 censored Yu-Gi-Oh card arts? No, I can't do that. Let's see here. Oh, yeah. SR staple qualities. I'm surprised these Duel Links Master Duel specific videos didn't perform as well. It's just my normal shit. Like, barely 100,000 views on each one of them, whereas all the other ones are just about normal topics did way better. I guess people don't want to know what the top 10 rare quality staples in Master Duel are. Oh, no, Duel Links. Never mind, that explains it. Nobody cares about Duel Links. How did the Master Duel ones do? Oh, they did way better. 150,000. Well, not way better, but they did do better. Yeah, so the Master Duel stuff came out. And this is, like, when I started the YouTube channel, the clip channel. Do you guys know this clip channel over here? Oh, I don't have it on this screen. I have to come down over here. We have the Duel Logs Duel Logs. I started this when Master Duel came out, and it was immediately successful and immediately surpassed my World of Warcraft channel in views per month. And just, like, earnings and everything. It's not as successful anymore because of, like, reasons I'll talk about later. Happy Easter. My Nibiru video. Summoning Nibiru 3 times against Virtual World to win. Literally what happened. I don't know why this video did well. Eldritch has a fusion monster. I guess the thumbnail was just clickbaity. The Hearthstone video makes sense. These ones make sense. But I don't get why the Eldritch video specifically did well. Yeah, so just like a whole bunch of clip channels. Profitable? It was more profitable. For a while. Yeah, the views have definitely dropped. I forget, how much did they used to get? I think they got like around 10 to 20,000 views each. And they went down to only like around 10,000. We love Papa Eldritch. Reversal quiz. I guess they don't do that bad. Yeah, so what happened was, at the beginning of the year, I started that channel, and I also had, I don't even have it in my list anymore, but my Hearthstone channel. I started both of those channels this year. And the way those started was, I thought the name would be funny. I thought if I had a channel called the Duel Logs would be funny. I just started the Hearthstone channel, and I knew I did not have the resources to, like, keep it up. I couldn't do it. Yeah, Rip the Tavern's Logs. And then I thought, the name is funny, and I'm very impulsive, so I just made it anyway. And I uploaded a video. I don't think you can even scroll by your oldest videos anymore. You just gotta, like, scroll all the way down. Top 10 drugs tested live. Shut up, Stevie. So this video was immediate. This channel, I Can't Stop Winning with Worms. It was a Duel Links video. It was just a VOD I had. And then all the other videos I uploaded started doing super well. It was crazy. I've never had a channel so successful before in the beginning. Usually they have to work so hard for their views. This one didn't. It was just immediately successful. And because of that, I didn't know, like, what was going on. Like, I didn't know why it was doing well. So it kind of freaked me out a bit. And then I stopped working on it. Then it, like... didn't do as well anymore because I wasn't uploading as much. Yeah, and then we started the Hearthstone channel. So the Hearthstone channel came about because a dude came up to me in my business email, and he's like, "Hey, have you ever thought about starting a Hearthstone channel? Because you have, you know, like your World of Warcraft, the Yu-Gi-Oh, and your D&D channel. Would you like to start a third one? Like, I'm a semi-pro Hearthstone player. I can like help you with it." And I told him, "No, absolutely not, because we have so many development hell problems with the D&D channel and the World of Warcraft channel. And I have a person who goes through my emails in order to deal with my ad people, you know, the ads for like HelloFresh and stuff. And they sent me a message and like, are you having problems with your channels? I can help you out if you want." And I was like, I don't want your help. So I told him, no, everything's fine. I was just, you know, trying to let them down politely. And they sent me a message like, "This seems like a good opportunity. Are you sure?" And I was like, "All right, I'm good. So I messaged them back. I'm like, "Yeah, we can totally do the Hearthstone channel. I'm totally not overwhelmed at the moment. Thanks for the sub, Raishin." So that's how it started. We got him on, and we hired some new people to work on the Hearthstone channel. And he was like a machine with scripts. He was pumping out scripts like crazy. And we were doing great, but our editors weren't fast enough, so I had to hire a new one. And the new editor was faster than the scriptwriter, and then the scriptwriter got lazy. And I had to like keep telling him, like, "Hey, you need to make scripts faster." And he's like, "Yeah, okay, sure." And he kept giving me a bunch of excuses, and he just didn't do it. And eventually, I just stopped messaging him. Mr. Logs, you want a card on Nova stream? Nice. Let's go over to Nova's stream.
Because she's pretty, but like, Duel Logs like Snorlax a lot? Shit, I just gotta keep screaming things that Duel Logs likes, and eventually he'll come out. He really likes Akumiaoi, so Akumiaoi, hello!
Oh no, how does she know?
I'll lick my microphone if you come, Duel Logs! He's on his way, yeah!
What did you win?
What did I win?
A card giveaway?
We're doing a card game giveaway. Card giveaway, bestie.
I think I already have three copies of all of these cards.
The Duel Logs.
Give me the Shizu card.
And I have a question. Yes, what's your question, bestie?
Card time, Duel Logs, let's go. I already have three copies into TIS. I don't need any more.
Shizu card? The fuck is that?
You don't know what a Shizu card is? It's like right there in the middle.
Which ones are those?
It's right in the middle. Mr. Moneybags.
The fuck?
I think I have three copies of Natis. I'm pretty sure I have three copies
of
Natis.
The one on the front?
Yeah, Keldo.
Kaleido in the middle.
Was it Keldo?
This one? Oh. Is that what this is?
Yeah. Huh. Mr. Moneybags. Okay.
Do you want me to sign it for you, Duel Logs?
Yes, sign it. Natis is like $6 a copy on the bad day. They're not that bad. I already have three copies of Natis, though. Akumiaoi watches Nova? I don't think so. I think Nova only knows because all of my friends know. Rip sales value. Just make them earth and fairy.
No, I wrote on my mat. You hate to see it.
Why do VTubers hide their hands for videos? It's for immersion. Okay. All right. So, anyways, the Hearthstone channel. Having to constantly message the scriptwriter to just make scripts, I eventually had to hire a secretary to message people for me because it was a pain in the ass. And that's how I got a secretary whose sole job is just to message other people and tell them to do their jobs. And then, because the Hearthstone channel didn't work out, one of the editors had originally came to me and was like, hey, do you want to make a MTG channel? And I was like, heck no, I don't. I don't even like that game. But I am starting a Hearthstone channel. You can work on that. And the Hearthstone channel failed. So I was like, hey, you still into making the MTG channel? And they're like, yeah, of course. And so we started that. And they wrote the scripts and they did all the editing and it did very good. It performed way better than everything else. And then when I was in Stevie's chat, I was just in his chat. I don't know what I was doing. I was probably trolling or spamming something. And they brought up the topic of Pokemon, and I was like, hell yeah, I'd love to make a Pokemon channel. And someone was like, hey, are you serious about that? And I was like, not really. But let's work something out. And then I got the Pokemon channel off the ground because of that. The spam logs. I do like to go into other people's chats and just, like, spam stupid shit. That's fun. Is your company official name? Yeah, I think it's just Haruma Red. Or Haruma Red X. I don't remember. Yeah, that's the company. So, like, up to a certain point, if I look at all of the videos from, like, when Master Duel came out, because Master Duel was, like, super successful, too. Like, let me bring up the Twitch stats. Final Fantasy channel? Oh, hell no. I'm never making another channel about a goddamn freaking... What the hell is it even called? An MMO. I hate MMO channels. They're such a pain in the ass. Card game channels all the way. So, look at this graph. Ooh, December I streamed a ton. So, like, this is when I started streaming in December. Then, January, still just doing Master Duel Links. Growing at a nice, reasonable pace. Well, you guys can't probably see this very well. Right here, look. See? 50 average viewers at the very beginning. So you hate Hermit X? No, I love the channel. It's just a pain in the ass. I just don't want to do another one. Then in January, still only streaming Duel Links. 300 average viewers. Then in February, 500. This is when Master Duel came out. I think Master Duel came out the end of January. And then March, ooh, full Master Duel hype stuff. 700 average viewers. April, still around 700. May, still around 700. The channels were doing well. The videos were also doing super well. Everything was doing great. Look at all these views. We started the clip channel. The clip channel was doing amazing. It was performing better than the World of Warcraft channel, which was still a mess. And then in June, it just started falling. And then July, it fell. And then 300. Oh, look, and then it started going up a little bit. And now we evened out at around 400. I kind of missed the PK. What's the PK? Did you lose your subs at the Masters of the Hype End? Let's take a look at Farfuzz and MBT's channel for comparison. So, my drop happened in June. We look at theirs, May, June. Oh, look, it dropped and then went back up. Oh, look, he even had a better month in August. I think that's when he did Subathon or something. And then 2000, and then it dropped because he didn't stream for like 2 months. So, like, pretty steady graph. And we go over MBT's, May, 1300, June, 1400, 1300, 1600. See, a steady growth. So, like, what's the difference? You know, we're all Master Duel streamers. We can't see the graph. Oh, fuck. Here, I'll show it again. Oh, no, I'll just do this one and zoom in. Okay. Oh, my God. Okay, so this is Farfa's graph. If you look at Farfa's graph, May 2400, this was when I had my peak, and then it drops down to 1800 in June because he streamed a lot less. And then it goes back up, and it goes back up, and then it drops because he didn't stream for 2 months. And then we come over here to MBT's. If we look at his May graph, because, like, remember, these are both big Master Duel streamers as well. 1,300 in May, and then in June, 1,400. An increase. And then it went down a little bit, and then it goes up in 1,600, and then 1,400, 1,400, 1,600, 1,500, 1,500. Look at this. They're going up. They both did not have a huge drop in June, like my channel did. Look, really came out of nowhere. Yeah, there's other people who are doing well, too. Like, no one else had, like, a huge drop-off in June. How about DK? No, they're all the graphs are about the same. Overall, pretty steady growth. Yeah, mine is, like, a steady decline after June. You see, there's one big difference between my channel and theirs. Is, in May, my friend died. So in June, I talked about it all the time. And I just didn't stop. That's the big difference. Oh my god, they're going crazy with the fireworks because it's almost midnight. Oh man, my dogs do not like it at all. Ooh, it's almost New Year's. Oh, it is New Year's. After Master came out, a lot of people got into Yu-Gi-Oh! Community. Yeah. That's maybe something. It is. Yeah, now we can hear it. Let's go over to Social Blade. I wonder if we can see some graphs over on Social Blade, too. Oh, I don't have Ice Moon showing. Can you guys hear the fireworks going off? They certainly are having a blast with the fireworks. Oh my god, look at that drop. The mana logs has always done well. The D&D logs, the Dex logs. Which graph? You guys can't see it because I haven't moved it over yet. Desktop one. Okay. Okay. What's your favorite channel to record the scripts for? I don't know. Look at these numbers. 2,000 at the very beginning. And then in May it was 1,500,000. June? Ooh, it actually had a upcrease in June. And then in July it started going down. Because we started releasing less and less videos. The D&D logs. I wonder if the graph looks similar over here. Oh wow, there was a huge uptick in September randomly. Why do I get the vibes that logs lives in AC? I do. Dex log starts up at 500,000 and then goes down to 139,000. That's what happens when I don't constantly advertise the channel. And then the dual logs. Best month was February, of course. And then second best month was July randomly. Yeah, the uptick isn't really as noticeable as the others. It's just when I start uploading shorts. Shorts are crazy good for your channel. Damn, the graph is absurd. You also kind of stop streaming. YouTube streams doesn't really matter that much. If we come over here, we see like a steady decline in the dual logs. It was doing so good. We were getting so many views. All the videos were popping off. And then around this time period, my editors just did not work on as many videos as they used to. We used to have such a surplus of videos. We had a video every day, and then we started dropping to like a video every other day. And then a video like a couple times a week. And that just kept happening, and I was just not in the mood to edit myself. And I didn't actually start editing myself until like around over here, and I still don't really do it very often. So it's just on a big steady decline ever since. I love your estimated earnings. Oh, let's look at the estimated earnings. $164 to $2.6K. Oh my goodness gracious. True. It is around the middle of that. The mana logs. It's way higher than that, actually. 500,000. Ooh, this one averages around 500,000. That's pretty good. 1.9K. Did you ever do a branded engine video? No, of course not. September is when D&D 1 was announced, right? No, I think I just released a good video that did well. That's probably all it was. Or maybe, I don't know, was one D&D announced in September? I don't know. The D&D channel just randomly performs well and then doesn't. Because it is so inconsistent in the uploads, it's ridiculous. We never have, like, consistent uploads on this goddamn channel. I hate it. Ooh, it's not doing half bad recently. The Shady Dealings and then the Dex Logs channel. The videos that we've just been producing just haven't been performing as well recently. That's because the ideas are kind of weird. The branded engine. Logs, do you ever get tired of all this? Like, do you feel like you'll retire eventually? Seems like a lot of work. Great question, the Wild Davis. It is a lot of work. It's too much work. It stresses me out all the time. This is my number one source of, like, stress, is all this shit. Do you do more collabs with other Pokemon content creators? No, it's just like the videos just haven't been as, the scripts haven't been as good. Because we had some problems with the script writers in the back end. Like, the two people who started off with the channel don't really work on it anymore. And we got two new script writers, then we had, like, a problem with, like, plagiarism with one of them. And the other one, we have a problem where his videos are just, like, very bare bones. And the ideas they picked to work on were all just, like, super generic and not super interesting. But I don't know Pokemon well enough to really fix those problems. All we just need to do is have those two new script writers just, like, you know, get more experience, I guess. I don't know how fucking complicated Pokemon is nowadays. This Pokemon's not complicated. The Pokemon viewers were surprisingly interested. Yeah, the videos are getting there. We have some decent ones. We just, like, the quality of our scripts has gone down. That definitely translates to lower views. But just because you have a good quality script doesn't mean the video will do well. You still need good ideas, too, and the ideas just haven't been very good either. But they're trying their best. I don't want to talk too much smack on our script writers and stuff. Let's see over here. Top 10 game clips for new players. Ooh. Interesting to know. I'm a doctor in training. I can relate that people always see the end result and think your life is great, but don't realize the work and stress that goes into it. I appreciate your honesty and transparency. Yeah. I remember, wow, I actually streamed even more in June. I really shouldn't have done that. Streaming right now? Whoa, Hazukashi. Best part of this clip was all memes inside him. They're just so funny, entertaining. Yeah, we don't really have his memes as much anymore. So what happened was, after May, I stopped giving people reminders. And without me to constantly give them reminders, they just didn't do their jobs, unfortunately, and I lost a lot of money because of that. And then of course I went crazy and I started to start a bunch of new channels, and then I started a new series because I was just, like, you know, taking a break and I was trying new things. I was like, hey, I'm gonna promote these channels by uploading some of their videos onto my channel. And then they couldn't keep up with the output of that, and, like, the Magic videos were just performing better on the Magic channel than they did over here. And the Hearthstone channel, we just didn't have enough scripts because our scriptwriter wasn't working. Self-sabotage equipment cards. Maybe you should stream as a way to cope with your loss. Seems understandable. Maybe you streamed as a way to cope with your loss. Well, the coping thing was, like, I've never had a loss that big before. So, you know, I thought, hey, mentally, I'm probably fine. I just didn't know until like after the fact. It's like only thinking in hindsight. I was like, oh, I probably should have taken a break. Because with the knowledge of hindsight, I know that I wasn't okay. And that I probably shouldn't have like brought all that negative energy on stream. But like, I didn't know. I thought it'd be fine. Long as he doesn't cope, he just ignores his problems. I do. I ignore all my problems. Do you have to make content that you hate? But know it hoards views and helps sustainability? If so, which topics? Do I have content that you hate making? Yeah, I hated making the explaining the ban list videos. But I just wanted to complete it. Usually if I don't like doing something, I just don't do it. I like all the stuff I do. I like top 10 videos. I don't know about you guys, but I like top 10 videos. They're fun. I like watching them. I like making them. I like the failed card series. I like the clip videos. I like the stuff that I do. This is a fun job. The Watch Mojo logs. Well, the thing is, I think my videos are good. Not every top 10 video is good. It's hard to find people who make top 10 videos as good as I do. But there are people who can accomplish that. They just don't upload as much as I do because this is actually like very difficult to do. I like to explain ban list series. I was hoping there would be why it's limited and or simulated series. The reason there isn't a limited or simulated series because I hated doing the series. It was a pain in the ass. And the reason I hated doing it is because it required so much research. Because like, there's like, it's just not written down anywhere. Nobody writes this shit down. You have to like go through and look through so much shit. And so many of the videos, like when someone would like talk about. So, like, I know you guys have seen it. Like, whenever a new ban list drops, people will make videos reacting to the ban list, and they never explain why something was banned. They'll just be like, hey, Thunder Dragon Colossus was banned. Ugh, aren't you guys all tired of playing against that? I'm sure glad it's banned now. And then just not talk about why it was banned. They'll just say, well, yeah, of course this card was banned. It's so obvious. And then not, like, explain the obvious thing. So you have to look for that shit yourself, and it's such a pain in the ass. Because a lot of times cards are not banned for the reason you'd think they are. As you explained, the ban list did very well. It did do very well. But I didn't like making it. Because it was a huge pain in the ass. The only reason I made this series in the first place was because I wanted to make a video on the top 10 like worst banned cards, or like the strongest banned cards. And the information for it was just terrible. There was no information on it. So I was like, well, might as well make a series where I explain this shit since the resource literally doesn't exist. And then I found out why it doesn't exist, because it's too much work. Which cards were banned for unexpected reasons? Pretty much all of them, without exception. You look at a card and you're like, wow, this card seems strong. And you're like, well, actually it was banned because of this really ridiculous combo. Or like, actually it was banned because it's just like a ridiculous consistently tool. Or like last turn, for example, like, why is this card banned? It's like, oh, it's because I just forgot to take it off the ban list. It's like, oh. Well, I guess we gotta look at the history of it, of why the card is banned. Or like self-destruct ban, like, why is this card banned? It's like, oh, it really doesn't need to be. But it was banned originally because of this reason. I was like, oh, okay. Why is that a problem? Well, I don't know. Figure it out for yourself, idiot. Hello, fellow loggers. We have Happy New Year's. Yes, Happy New Year's. I feel as if I had this as a job, I'd hit a creative wall. Not really. We have like a million ideas. Here's my Trello board just for shorts ideas. It's not even that long, actually. We have the actual Yu-Gi-Oh board. Let me open up the Yu-Gi-Oh board. That one's a little bit more bigger. This is where our people go in order to pick out ideas to work on. So they're all like future videos. Can you please explain the differences in the OCG and the TCG in terms of gameplay? Yeah, OCG gets cards earlier, and the people there just like to play the game differently. There you go! Maybe they ban a card for promo reasons. Last term, Soul Strike Bunner banned because it's Nightmare in tournaments. Nobody would play them. They're garbage cards. So you have to like look for like why they were banned in the first place. I saw the Trello Bird. Time to steal the topics and make my own top tens. You see, the great thing about my videos is they're so hard to make that you can't copy me. You don't have the resources. You don't have the time or the staff to do this. This is too much work for one person to do. And if you have the resources, why would you want to steal top 10 ideas? We can just make your own. Most people like to do their own ideas. They don't give a shit about your ideas. Do you ever wonder why nobody like does this? Like, these videos are obviously successful. Like, look at them. Like, they all perform like over 100,000 views each. Like, this is really good. Most of the channels don't really have these kinds of views and numbers. You ever wonder why nobody else does this? And instead, they all just copy, like, progression series? Because it's too hard. You can't. The startup cost for these types of videos in particular is just too much. Have you considered dropping one of these channels to free up some time? You might lose money, but I'm sure if you're working 24/7, there has to be diminishing returns at some point without the burnout. The Wild Davis. If I drop some of the channels, I would make more money, not lose money. I'm losing so much channel, so much money, ridiculous amounts of money, like pumping it into these new channels. If I wanted to focus on just making money, I would just dump everything and put it all into World of Warcraft and Yu-Gi-Oh! But I think the other channels have the opportunity to grow. They don't perform that badly. Like, we have the Duologs. Well, this channel also does really well for, like, just stream VODs. The Manologs, 500,000 views on average. That's pretty good. The D&D Logs, surprisingly, sometimes gets 500,000 views if we actually, like, upload good videos. Which is sustainable. The Dex Logs hit 500,000 views in its first month, which is redonkulous. If we had kept growing after that, that would have been so good. This one gets like 4 million views. Well, obviously. I don't think I have the WoW channel on here. Oh, I do have the WoW channel on here. Look at the WoW channel. Randomly got over 1 million views in November because the new expansion launched. Even though we released like no fucking videos. Look, we don't even have like a subscribers for the last 30 days because the channel like grows like once every 2 or 3 months. You go high effort / high reward, and then every other channel goes for low effort, high expecting rewards. Yeah, that's what we do. We go with high effort, high rewards, and it usually works out. Usually. It just takes a while to get to it because we're not spamming videos. But also the Duologs is basically, you know, that. We release like one video a day. And it also worked. It's not working out recently, but that's just because we haven't been uploading as much. Like, this is when I stopped micromanaging the channel, is when it dropped. If I don't, like, directly micromanage shit, like, they just don't, you know. The people who I hire are just not as motivated as I am. They vastly prefer it if I'm constantly giving them reminders. Like, to the point where they literally ask for it. They're like, please, constantly give us reminders. And I'm just like, do your fucking jobs. Just do your job. Do you not want your money? Yeah, exactly. It's so frustrating. So I just don't think about it. Reminder. Oh my god, they all want reminders. Like, as I hired someone whose whole job is just to get people reminders. And it boosted productivity. By so much that it's almost sad. Yeah, they want someone to remind them to do their jobs. Having someone to remind them to do their jobs actually, like, gets them to do their jobs. Because the money is not a motivator, which is just baffling to me. Because I pay way above rate. I pay so much above rate that, like, the best thing I could probably do if I wanted to, like, save money would be to fire everybody and then hire new staff at a much lower rate. But that would be fucked up. I was like, because, like, I hiring people at a higher rate, it's not working. They're just not doing their jobs. So there's no reason to pay them above rate. Money's a huge motivator for me. If you ever start hiring them in the future, please don't fire me. I don't want to fire you, Lily. You're, like, one of our best workers. If we look at all the channels, I think the Duologues has all of them on it. We have Haruma Red, definitely the one with the workers who need the most reminders and still don't do their jobs anyway. The Duologues. I stopped giving them reminders. I just do it myself. I gave up. They still do their jobs. Like, one of the guys, I basically just have him work on all the thumbnails now. But, yeah, they definitely lost their motivation. They still do work. Like, don't get me wrong. It's just they don't do as much work as they used to. The D&D channel? Absolute nightmare with motivation all around. I had to hire a new manager because my last one would just not do his job for months. And every time we hire a new editor for the channel, they quit. We had one good editor, but we unfortunately moved them over to the Manalogs channel. And that was the only time we had a consistent editor for the channel. We have a new editor. He watches the streams too. And in the last stream, he was like, yeah, I really need motivation. And I was like, oh my god. I specifically hired you because in your application, you said you had a monotonous clerk job for years. Both of them. Is it Fel? No, it's not Fel. Fel does a good job. And then the Manalogs. This channel is great. No problems. The Dexlogs. One of the editors is good. The other one turned in their first video after 2 months today. We hired on two editors when we started the channel. Lily in chat has been doing great, doing all their jobs. And the other one, who we hired at the same time, finished their first video today. I forgot we had a second editor. Not for long. Public shaming? They're not watching this. Oh, that's all the channels. So let's see, out of all of them, we have the Duologues channel, which is perfect. No problems there. And the Manalogues channel, which is perfect. No problems there. So the problem channels are the Dexlogues, the D&D logs, the Duologues, and Haruma Red X. So if we found some way to get all these channels just, like, good to go, we should have figured this out months ago because I'm running out of money. I'm not out of money yet, but January ad revenue is really low, and I'm really close to running out of money to supply them. Play more Pokemon? No. Don't forget to give a shout out to your fastest editor. Yeah. Worst comes to worst, we can just move all the good editors to the Duologues channel. And then just put the other ones on maintenance mode. One video every week. And then just let go the editors who don't work as fast. If anything, Logs needs to stream less. I do need to stream less. Streaming is not profitable. Well, in comparison to working on my other shit, it's not profitable. It's just, like, not as profitable as just working on YouTube instead. Like, if I just made a WoW video myself instead of streaming, that would benefit my goals more. It's more profitable. It is like, it doesn't do half bad because we have the clip channel too, and we have the main channel, and, like, their revenues together equal a decent amount, but it's like 1/4 of what the Yu-Gi-Oh! Channel makes, And it's less than what the WoW channel makes. And the WoW channel is run like garbage. When will you play fighting games with Mogu? I'll play one tomorrow. Clearly you need to stream, you're working on videos? No, streaming editing is boring. When it comes to streams, you need to be entertaining. You can't just do whatever you want. That's why these earlier streams did so much better, because I was actually like putting effort into them. And then I stopped, and that's when it went down. I was also complaining a lot about stuff. If you're depressing on stream all the time, turns out people don't want to watch that, which is reasonable. It's super, you know, it's not a good vibe when you tune into a stream and the person's just like talking about such heavy topics all the time. Honestly, if you really wanted to cash in on your streaming, you should just actually make merch. Merch doesn't really make money, though. That's why we have secret Twitter accounts. Yeah, a secret Twitter account, which too many people are following, so I don't post on it negatively as much as I used to. Because I don't know if I can really, like, you know, completely overstate just how devastating of an event it was in May. Like, easily the worst thing that's ever happened to me. And the fact that I was still functional at all is just, like, amazing. That's a lot of stream hours in December. Why did I stream so much in December? I'm surprised you continued. Yeah, I just, like, didn't know what to do. It was so out of left field. I watched the video. It was very heartfelt. Yeah, I went a little bit crazy after it happened. I just did a whole bunch of random shit. And I think I still haven't really recovered. You know, I always talk about, you know, I'm just ignoring my problems on stream and stuff. All my problems are basically just that. What happened in May? In May, my best friend died. You've seen how it's been going on in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Space? One person buying merch generates more income than all the videos of merch in a lifetime. Wait, what? You weren't translating your vision to actual income. A merch is an easy way to do that. One person buying merch generates more income than all of the videos they would watch in their lifetime. Oh, yeah, that's true. But, like, it's still not a lot. Anyone on vacation in December? Oh, yeah, I did. That was an experience. That's rough. I'm sorry to hear about your friend. Yeah, I try not to talk about it. I'm talking about it today because I'm doing a year-end review. However, during streams and stuff, I try very hard not to. A vacation. Yeah, the vacation was basically just going across the country on a whim. Because I can't control my impulses very well. I can control them. I just can't control them very well at the moment. You're doing great? Why, thank you. I'm getting real good at ignoring my problems. It seems to help. I'm a lot happier. As long as I just don't think about it, I'm good. I try to talk about it, literally mention it every stream. I don't like mention it specifically, but like it was such a major thing that impacted my life that it's kind of hard to not talk about it because it comes up a lot. Happy New Year's logs? Yes, Happy New Year's. Margins on merch aren't usually good. Yeah, merch isn't super like profitable. I think people mainly do merch just because everybody else does it. It's just like one of those things YouTubers do because other YouTubers do it. You know, like the whole, hey guys, please like and subscribe my video before we start this video. You know, the first 30 seconds of the video doing a shout out, a call to action, even though it's stupid. It's okay if you do Mr. Logs. It's okay if I do what? Getting lost in airports and trying to brute force it. I should not travel alone. It stresses me out every time, and I get lost every time. But I don't have anyone to travel with, so I have to do it. And I hate it. I just am not good with directions, and I ignore signs. And I can't not do it, because I just, like, don't think... I remember in this last trip, I was like, I'm going to make sure I read everything. I'm going to look up stuff. I'm not going to get lost this time. I immediately get lost in the airport as soon as I get there. And I was like, God damn it. How does this always happen? No one else gets lost as much as I do. Possible thing to do because I hire a manager and they get told they should do merch? I guess. Is it proof that saying like and subscribe helps grow? No. It's like, they've done experiments, studies. It's very circumstantial. But the likelihood of people subscribing for them not subscribing, if you don't tell them, it's about the same. To an extent. It, like, depends on your audience and, like, what type of stuff you do. There are certain audiences where if you tell them, it will increase it. And there's certain audiences where if you tell them, it won't. Because, like, the type of videos you make. Overall, if you make good videos, people will just do it on their own. If you make your video specifically about engagement, people will engage with the videos. There's other ways to do it rather than just asking people to do it. Especially since so many people just ask them to do it, they just kind of ignore it. I hate that. I hate the first thing the video is just someone kind of adds. Yeah, that's why I made that video of making fun of it. Merch makes viewers feel more connected to the content. Like how streamers interact with them. If you own branded merch, you're inherently more attracted to the brand without it. I guess, but like with these numbers, I wouldn't sell very much merch anyway. These numbers aren't very good. Like, you know, compared to like really big streamers. It's good versus, you know, compared to small streamers. Like, since I have these numbers, I always thought I'm basically a small streamer. So I interact with other small streamers. But they all treat me like a big streamer because I average 400 viewers. And it's like, that's not even a lot. Why are you treating me like this? Just treat me like a normal person. Mr. Logs, how are we doing? How are we doing? Every day I'm sad. So I hate that question. How am I doing? Oh great, I have to lie again. Yes, I'm doing great. Life is amazing. You're a decent sized streamer with a huge following? Decent size? I don't know about that. I just remember, I always considered myself a small streamer because these numbers aren't like enough to like quit the YouTube channel stuff. The YouTube stuff is so much more successful. So I interact with other small streamers. But because of like the success, you know, quotations, success of this, of these numbers, and in the Twitch and the YouTube stuff, they just like, they put me on a pedestal and I don't like it. That's why I stopped doing collabs. I hated it. It pissed me off so much. Breaking 120 is kind of hard. Yeah, I imagine. Hi, you're still streaming. Hey, Stimpak, you're still awake? Oh, you must have got back from your party. You are a big YouTuber? I'm like a medium, I guess. Like, the actual big YouTubers have like millions of subs. Combined across all my channels, I don't have a million subs yet. How's your sleep been? Have you finished sleeping more than usual in the past 2 weeks? No, I sleep normal amounts. I just got back. Happy New Year? Excellent. Happy New Year, Stim. I hope you had a fun time at your friend's house. Top 7,000 amongst all streamers, though. That doesn't mean anything, though. Twitch is tiny. And, like, just streaming has, like, that whole, if you're not in the top 100, you're not a real big streamer. And I'm definitely not in the top 100. I'm in the top 7,000, which is, like, nothing. Did you get more views on your YouTube stream, though? That's true. I do get a lot more views on my YouTube stream. A medium-sized streamer is probably what you are? Probably. You're too used to high degrees of success. There are full-time streamers with half your stats, and you're still way above them. Yeah, probably. I think, yeah, that was it. I was, like, too used to my success, so I thought I was, like, a small-time streamer. So it was, like, a huge blindside when I found out everybody put me on a pedestal. And I was like, I don't like this. Just treat me like a normal person. I'm not even that big. Small streamers like stream to 30 or less? Probably. The biggest in your field? I'm not the biggest in my field. When people ask me how it's going, I always answer it's going not great, not bad. It's just going. Aren't you the top 3 YouTubers in subs? You are on my pedestal. Why, thank you, Stim. However, I like that you don't put me on a pedestal. I really hope you don't. Asha, I know you don't. I've known you for 11 years. You knew me before I started doing YouTube. Top 3 in subs? We can, like, take a look at it over here. Subs. Oh, I have some Yu-Gi-Oh! People in here. I'm the 4th most sub channel. We have Team Sam, Team BPS, Decade, and then me. Hello, I know you're a normie. Heck yeah. I would consider you well-known, been watching you for years? Yeah, like in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Community, for sure. Because apparently I'm the 4th most subscribed to channel. I gotta get those numbers up higher. Dang, more than Simo. That's impressive. When it comes to actual views, I think I'm like the 2nd or 3rd most. These are total views, which is different from average of a 30-day. The average of the 30 days... There's someone else who has, like, shorts videos that are doing really well. But the only person who consistently beats me in views per month is Team Samurai. Hey, slowly becoming a degen? I'm not becoming a degen. I'm used to watching you when you stream Duel Links. Hell yeah, I loved Duel Links. Shorts don't really transcribe to income, though. Same with TikToks. Yep, that's 100% true. But they do give you more eyes on your channel, which is a big benefit. It's basically like free promotions. I wish there was a way to separate like shorts views from normal views, because they combine them. Team Samurai also uploads like every day. Yeah, he does a good job. I want to start uploading every day too. They bring in views. Yeah, shorts are really good at bringing in views. Starting to do shorts was like a really good decision I made in the past year. No? Team Salem collabs, opens packs like crazy though. Kind of hard to match him. The thing is, I only have one editor still working on the channel, even though the channel does really well. For the longest time, it just, like... Working on the channel stresses me out, so I just don't think about how to optimize them. And it's only this month that I was like, huh, maybe I should put more editors onto the Yu-Gi-Oh! Channel. Maybe I shouldn't have my most successful channel with just a single editor while all the other ones have like more than one. Uploading every day would burn you out instantly compared to your current WordPress. No, I have a team of people. We have 30 people on staff. It's 100% just about allocating resources to the channel, which I just haven't done. Like, I just operate on a different level from, like, other YouTubers in this same field. There are other YouTubers who also have, like, you know, a huge staff like I do. I just, like, am not a very good manager. And I just, like, don't make these decisions, and I just kind of, like, diddly-daddle. And I spend too much time streaming instead of actually, like, you know, micromanaging. And if I don't micromanage, then they don't do their jobs. So that was something I worked on a lot in the past year. Like, I had conversations with Leah and Riri, just asking them about, like, business stuff. It was like, how do I do this? I need tips. You guys know business stuff. I need to absorb your business knowledge. And they gave me books to read, and I read all the books, and I was like, okay, I think I know what to do now. Even if you ignore the mental stress, the physical stress will eat away at you unless you actually work to resolve that. What physical stress? I work on my channels like 4 hours a day. And we upload like 500 videos a year. I think I know what I'm doing to an extent. I just like don't optimize it well enough. Dependable employees are hard to come by. Like, there's a whole bunch that goes on in the background to like get the employees prepared. Like, I know some people will come in chat and is like, if you have script writers and you have editors, what exactly do you do? And it's like, well, who do you think trains them? Who do you think teaches them how to do this shit? You stream too much. I do stream too much. I should really stop. It's just I get lonely, and streaming ebbs the loneliness. And it's very addictive. It's like, ooh, if I stream, I just don't have the urge to hang out with people anymore. Because it feels the same exact social need. Yeah, exactly. It's like it's a fun thing, and also the stream is somewhat successful. Like the clips too also don't do half bad. And I like doing it. Like, I'm here for a similar reason. Yeah, like it's like I almost feel sorry for people who can't stream if they're lonely. They have to be a stream watcher. And it's way more fun being the streamer than it is being the stream watcher. I discovered Team Samurai literally yesterday. Looked for a few of their videos, and I honestly can say they're kind of meh. Yeah, he's not for everyone. Like, I don't watch his videos, but I can understand, like, his appeal. I don't really watch most of YugiTubers, though. If I watch Yu-Gi-Oh! Videos, it's to, like, look up deck profiles, and that's it. Or sometimes to watch hard leg videos. Physical stress doesn't necessarily come from volume of work, but the intensity of the situation. I don't know what you're trying to like get at. You're saying I work too much, working 4 hours a day. I'm going to sleep now. See you later, Ram. Rye Ram. Wait, then are you hiring people who have no idea how to do your job? Yes. 100%. What I do is I look for people who have experience in other works. So like when it comes to like hiring people for like script writing, I hire people specifically who have like some experience in that field, and then I just show them my tutorial videos and I work with them as they write scripts, and I give them a shit ton of like edits so that way they can write in my style. Like, I have how I write my videos down to a science, and I have that all like, you know, in tutorial videos and like documents and like files and stuff that I send to them. And they have to, like, study all that, and they have to, like, replicate how I do stuff, and they send it back to me, and it's usually terrible at first. I have to give them a bunch of corrections. And then after a few videos, they get it, and then it's good to go. And when it comes to editing videos, same thing. I have a whole bunch of tutorial videos I made. Like, here's how to edit exactly how I do. And then they do the videos, they send it back to me. The first ones are usually always terrible, and I give them a whole bunch of corrections. Like, you know, paragraphs of corrections. And I give it back to them, then they send it back, and eventually they get the hang of it, and then I don't have to, like, give them corrections anymore. Don't give away all your secrets? Yeah, it's just, like, it's a huge process to train someone new. But, like, when it comes to editing itself, you don't actually need to know the topic to do it. Like, my Yu-Gi-Oh! Editor, for example, my best Yu-Gi-Oh! Editor, the one who made, like, all these videos, doesn't know how to play the game. She's never played Yu-Gi-Oh! Before. You don't need to know because of the way the videos are set up. And she also didn't know how to edit before she started working on the channel either. I had to train her. And she does great. I have lots of experience in monotonous soldiering work. I'm terrible at writing though, but I could probably copy someone's writing style. Yeah, most people can copy my writing style. Because like I have it like, you know, I could show you the videos, but they're really boring to watch, and they're really long. I could show you the tutorial videos. I have shown them before my secret stream. And they're just kind of boring to watch, to be honest. Can you pay me in crypto? Hell no. Don't give away all your secrets. They literally can't copy me. I'm just like telling them how I do stuff. It's too hard to copy what I do. the hardest of legs. Like, the guy who rated every Yu-Gi-Oh deck, he really seemed to know his stuff. Yeah. Like, a lot of the people who I have who write the scripts for the videos, like, they actually, like, go to YCSs and, like, top events and stuff. Like, they do, they're really good. Same with the people who work on the Pokemon videos and, like, all of the stuff. Like, they're all just, like, really good people who play the game, like, in the group chat for, like, the work stuff. They'd be like, hey, anybody going to this YCS? So, like, yeah, I'll be there. I was like, man, I should probably go to some of these. I don't... Like, pretty much all my Yu-Gi-Oh! Script writers probably know more about the game than I do. And same with all my D&D script writers. They know more about the game than I do. And obviously the Magic and Pokemon script writers know more about the game than I do. I can copy what you do. Am I allowed to, or will be met with your lawyers? Have you ever considered selling the process, like if you have materials and stuff? It's very specific to what I do. Like, it's not generic enough. Like, if I gave someone my tutorial videos and they just try to do it on their own channel that wasn't specifically about card games, I don't know if it would work. Unless they were just, like, really bad. I just gave, like... Because, like, the tutorials are incredibly specific to what I do. So you can't really use it to, like, make other videos. I prefer voice typing to writing. Oh, I use a program that transcribes my voice into text when I do scripts because I can't type long stretches at a time because my hand is messed up. It probably wouldn't actually be hard to copy the video itself, but it would likely never see success because the niche is already filled with your audience, wouldn't grow. No, you could definitely copy what I do and succeed. Turns out people like to watch scripted, highly edited videos. The problem is they're really hard to make and they're not fun. It's way more fun to make videos that are easy to make. Are you familiar with Ruxin? I've always wondered how pack opening channels stay afloat considering most of the stuff they pull is a neg. Ruxin? Yeah, he sent me a message recently. I gotta reply to him. It was like, would you like it if I sent you like 24 packs of an old set and you just recorded and sent me the footage? And I was like, I could do that, but I don't really want to give you my address. And I don't want to go check my P.O. box. I have a P.O. box. I just like, I don't like going to check it because it's kind of annoying because it's really far away. But I'll probably tell him, yeah. An old set. I don't know what it is, but I like Ruxin. He's a cool guy. So if he wants me to be in one of his videos, I'll totally do it. I just forgot to reply to him. Sometimes people send me messages and I just like don't reply to them for a while. Like Blizzard sent me a message. They're like, hey, do you want to do like a super big interview with one of our like lore people? And I was like, I do, but I kind of forgot to reply for 5 days. ADHD is a hell of a drug. I don't have ADHD, though. I just forget. You should do it? Yeah. I've been following you for years? Why, thank you. When was the last time you checked your P.O. box? So, Miwa sent me some stuff in my P.O. box. And she kept asking me when I was going to check it. And I was like, I don't know. And then randomly, my secretary came to visit. I was like, hey, I checked your P.O. box for you. Here's the shit that was in there. And I was like, thanks. So that was the last time I checked it. Oh, I think the last time I went before they just gave me this stuff in my P.O. box was when I went to go get like a photo for my passport. Because it was at the post office. And we just went to the one where my P.O. box was at. Because we also needed to change the P.O. box. Because we lost the key to it. Do the interview. I am going to do the interview. We already have it somewhat set up. It's just like they went on vacation. They're like, well, we'll talk about it again at the beginning of January. So we'll probably do the interview. The problem is I just don't have good enough questions to ask. So I'm like asking around for good lore questions. I'm pretty sure there's services where people can do the last leg delivery for your P.O. box. Really? I didn't know that. I don't have ADHD. I don't have ADHD. Are you still going to do it? Do what? He's been doing visits to other YouTubers where they guess the amount of certain rarities and stuff. You can get on that and broaden audiences. I mean, maybe. I don't know anything about the rarities of cards, though. Ruxin's a cool guy. Yeah, he is. I've talked to him a few times. You should probably check the P.O. box like every other week. They get really mad if it fills up and you never check it. That's what I do. I never fucking check it. Do you play Pokemon Go? No. Go find the red shirt dude. Dude has some lore knowledge. I think he follows me on Twitter. I could ask him. I forgot about him though. Okay. Anyways. That was my year-end review. Hopefully you guys learned a lot about the back end of YouTube channel stuff. As you probably know, it's super easy. Literally no effort at all into any of this. All you do is turn on the thing and go live and you just don't talk about your dead friend and boom. 100,000 subscribers. Happy New Year's, Logs. Happy New Year's. Yeah, it's so easy. The interview? I am going to do the interview. I did reply. I said I didn't reply for 5 days, but that means I did eventually reply. I just forgot. You know how it is. Sometimes you miss really important emails and you just forget about it. Easy peasy. Yeah. I'd probably ask Farfa since he's the only person in the Yuga community that plays WoW. I have World of Warcraft people I can ask, though. Like, I don't know if you guys know this, but I'm also in the World of Warcraft community. I can just ask World of Warcraft YouTubers. Or, like, my guild who plays World of Warcraft. I also have, like, World of Warcraft staff members. We have, like, 5 people who work on the channel who all play WoW. Instructions unclear. Started at Dead Friend Podcast. No, you don't want to do that. I saw this thing. I saw this post yesterday that I commented on my main account. The post was basically, like, this dad sends the suicide hotline $15 every month. And like it's like with a note that says like for Dan because it was his kid's allowance. And everyone in the comments was like, well, why didn't he help him when he was alive? And I replied, I was like, man, the comments here are crazy. You guys are assuming the dad didn't try to help. Sometimes if you try to help, it just doesn't work. Sometimes you're just too late. Sometimes you don't get them in the correct treatment fast enough. Yeah. And then my post got like 1,000 likes or something. I was like, God damn it. I really should not have replied on my main account with this. That's like, yeah, it's because I know from experience, unfortunately. Sometimes even if you do help them, it just doesn't work. So, who should we raid? Minnie? Is Minnie? Time to steal for Hero's main account? No, it was on the Duel Logs account. I mean, I should have did it on my alt account, the Hero Logs. Vince? You want me to raid Vince? Wait, why Vince? Is he doing something cool? Does he have Meowie on or something? Come celebrate the new year with me! !! Collab. Yeah, Vince, because Meowie. Vince is streaming. Vince is cute, bro. Yeah, Vince is nice. But there's also Hino, Bobina, and Minion. Minnie is on. I mean, there's lots of people in chat saying Vince. I guess we can just go to Vince. But Meowie? Minnie? What the hell is Minnie doing? She's just playing Pokemon. I'll probably go to Minnie's chat anyway. Sure, we'll go over to Vince, since you guys want Vince so much. We'll go over to Vince. You guys say whatever you want. I don't know. I don't have a raid message. Tell him Happy New Year, you person. Thanks for the stream, Spider. See you later, Lily.